the last days. The war of the last days. The war of the last days. We need Revelation 12:11, which is where the name of this conference is from. And they overcame by the blood of the Lamb. These are people who have testimonies. The things I've been telling you. They are the people who do not love their life, even unto death. They are the ones who overcome by the blood. There's a dimension of the blood these people know that others will never know. There's a dimension, because the blood is the power of the cross. There has to be power to establish this. The kingdom of God is not in words, but in power. Jesus said, all power in heaven and earth is given to me. Only those who are following him can access it. Because all power in heaven and earth has been handed to the Lord. Only those tied to him, only those loyal to him, only those bonded, those that are tied to him, those that have taken his yoke. Because all power in heaven and earth, it belongs to him. It is with him, the resurrected Lord. That's why those that don't follow are powerless. You may be proclaiming things, but there will be no power. Dominion is not established by words. It is established by power. Dominion is not established by words. There are men, the scripture says, their words never fell to the ground. Are we not tired of speaking things that never happened? Are we not tired of an empty words? The Ecclesia are a church of men with weighty words. It means that when they speak, spirit beings respond. Jesus said, don't you think I can now come with you? And he sent legions of angels. I thank you because I know you hear me always. And he said, he they that believe in me, the works that I do, they will do and greater. It will be the proof that we are following him. Do no one join me? Still I will fall. Do no one join me? Still I will fall. Still I will fall. No turning back. No turning back. Every word that you hear will be tried. The Bible said that the sower went out to sow. As soon as you leave this door, the word will be tried. But you can receive 60-fold, 30-fold, 100-fold. Your determination can be resolute. Your determination can be final. Your decision can be total. And even this, then grace is more than enough. Yeah, that's what I said. I suffer the loss of all things. Don't you go down to win Christ. Following Christ means the loss of all things. That's what it means. I'm telling you, that's what it means. Kathy Coma said it will cost you everything. Because God wants all of you. That's the thing. God wants all of you. He doesn't want some of you. He wants everything. That's the reason to cost you everything. God wants everything that you want. All of you. It is possible. I did it once. It is possible. I've never looked back since. I've been bruised. I've been rejected. I've been misunderstood. I've been misinterpreted. I've been insulted. I tell you. But I've not looked back once. I've not looked back. The men who are out of the former house, they are here to help you. The Bible says, see that you are compassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses. Run the race that is set before you. Lay aside every sin and weight that does so easily beset you, and run the race that is set before you. Say, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of your faith, who for the joy set before him endured the cross, despising the shame. Say, look at him, the one who endured so much contradiction from sinners, lest you be weary, because you say you're not even resisted unto God, striving against sin. Let him be your example. The Bible says, hereunto we are called, seeing that Jesus suffered for us to walk in his steps. He left us an example to walk in his steps. He said, who did not see, neither was God found in his mouth. When he was reviled, he reviled not. When he suffered, he threatened not. But he committed himself to the one who judges righteously. There is no temptation that is common to you, that is not common to man, the Bible says. He said, God is faithful. He will not even allow you to be tempted more than you are able. With the temptation, you will make a way of escape, that you may be able to bear it. He will not allow anything that is bigger than you to come your way. So you can trust him. This is a race you can run. It is a race you can run. It's not bigger than you. No. It's not bigger than Jesus. It's not bigger than Calvary. It's a race you can run. Is for those who have really decided to follow Christ. It's never done. It's not like years before. It's for those who have made that decision. God is looking at you now. He knows if it's total. He knows. God is looking at you now. He knows if it's total. He knows. He knows. Corrie ten Boom. Some of you know she's one of the major mentors of my life. Lived in the day of Hitler. And God used her mightily to help the Jews. But she said she will come, lay things down in meetings and go back. Even if she goes back, she'll take them back. She'll take them back. And one day, a minister came and asked, all the things you have been dropping at Jesus' feet in different meetings, where are they? Are they still at the altar? She looked inward and realized that she has taken back everything she ever laid down. This is one of the problems we have. But like I said, you don't die here, you die outside. What you do outside this door is what determines if you take back what is on the other. She said she will come and say, Lord, I laid down my money, I laid down my family, I laid down this one. But she will go out, somebody will ask her for something, she won't do. The things that she told God I will do, she will take it back. And that day she looked, her altar was empty. There was nothing there. Everything she ever laid down before, she had taken home with her. This year is not like any other year. God is looking at you. He knows if you will take it back. When decisions are total, grace overflows. That's the reason I'm reserving my prayer for just the end. Are you really, really, really? Are you really going to journey? An ecclesia is to arise. Are you committed to what God is doing on the earth now? To join your hands. To follow Him. This communion is a symbol of our unity. There is no denomination there. That the cross of Christ brought down every wall. Every wall. There's no arm of Paul. There's no arm of Apollos. The ecclesia will be a united people. They will arise from all the churches on the earth now, and bone will join to bone. People committed to what God is doing, searching for the city with foundations, whose builder and maker is God. And nothing will make you turn back, nothing. If you honor the blood, I don't even know how the church of today expects to be in power. Eh? When we have no honor for the blood. I keep telling people, most of us value our mother's blood than the blood of Jesus. You will do for your brother what you will not do for your sister in the Lord. Because your mother's blood connects the both of you, right? And Jesus' blood is what? A people that you abhor the blood. He said to me, bring back the blood to the church. If the blood is honored in the church, then this denominational laws, no church will even call itself a family. There's no church that is a family. We have only one family under the surface of the earth, is the family of God. Every church is a part of that family. Every part. Every church is a part. A part. God is doing something on the earth. The people that are committed only to what God tells them, not what I'm saying. So I always tell people, run everything I say by the Holy Spirit. Don't you ever do anything because I said this. Every genuine minister has no problem with people running things that they say. Never ever do anything because everybody said it. The Bible says, they that are led by the Spirit of God, watching them, and they are the sons of God. You are seeking a city that God is building. That's what you are looking for. When you find it, you join your hand. Honoring the blood that brought all of us to you. This is the greatest symbol of our unity. We are all partakers of His body. You take turns to get in your tongues, and I'll sprinkle the blood on you when you come this way. This is the blood of Jesus, the blood of sprinkling. The Bible says, speaks better things than the blood of you. It is our stronghold. It is a force of Mount Zion.
Yeah. I'm here to be a doctor, I'm here to be a doctor, I'm here to be a doctor. Well,